Hi guys, welcome back to the new video of Easy Tutorials. We have already published this UI design video using Adobe XD, where lots of people asked me to create this website design using HTML and CSS. So here in this video, I'm going to create this web page design using HTML and CSS. So don't skip and keep watching this video till the end. Now let's start this video. Here I have one folder, and in this folder I have so many images, icons, and one index.html file and one style.css file. Let me open my text editor, which is brackets editor. So this is my HTML file and this one is CSS file. You can see I have already connected HTML file with CSS with this line of code. Now we will come to the body tag, and here we will create one div, and class name I am using hero. Let's copy this class name and write it into the CSS file. For this, we will add height 100vh and background image linear gradient and this color. Here we are using linear gradient because we will add one dark layer over the background image. Next, background position, it will be center. Then background size, it will be cover. Now we'll come to the folder and open this HTML file with Google Chrome. Now you can see an image on this web page and one blue layer on this image. Now let's come back to the HTML file, and in this div we'll create another div, and this one I'm creating class name navbar, and in this navbar I'm creating one more div and the class name is navbar left. Let's duplicate this one and change it to navbar right. So we have two div in the navbar. Let's copy this navbar and add it into the CSS file. For this one, we'll write display flex. Now we'll copy the first column, which is navbar left. And for this one, we'll write flex basis 70%. Then copy the second one. And for this one, flex basis, it will be 30%. Here we will add height, it will be 12%, and for first one we are adding background white, and for second one also. Let's reload the web page so that you can see this navbar in white color. Now just come back to the CSS file and remove this background, and here we will add border bottom. It will be 1 pixel solid and this color. So after reloading this page, you can see border bottom line in the left column, and in the right column you can see a background color, which is white. Now just come back to the code again, and in the first div we'll add another div, and the class name I'm using navbar inner. Here we'll add one image, so I'm using img source, and the file name, which is logo.png. Let's reload the web page so that you can see this logo over here. It is at the corner. So just copy this class name navbar inner, write it into the CSS file. I will write it here, and for this one we'll add display flex. Align items, it will be center, padding 45 pixel, 50 pixel, 10 pixel, and again 50 pixel. Now you can see proper space around this logo. Next we will add some menu here. For that, just come back to the HTML file, and here we will add UL then LI. Here we will add anchor tag ahref, and link text I am writing men. Simply duplicate it and write women, and the third menu it will be boys, and the fourth one girls. Next I am writing new arrivals. So we have 5 menu here. Let's reload the web page. Now you can see all these links over this web page. Next we'll come to the CSS file and just copy this one, then write UL. For this one we'll add margin from left side 20 pixel, set index it will be 2. Let's duplicate it, and here we'll add li for list. Remove this one, and here we'll add margin 0 and 10 pixel. Display, it will be inline block. Let's duplicate it again, then write A for anchor tag. Text decoration, it will be none. And color, it will be white. That's it. Reload the web page and you can see all this menu over here. Next, we have to add font family. So just come here and here we will add font family. Sans serif. Reload the web page and you can see different font style. Now we'll come to the right column of navbar. So just copy this one and paste it into the right column. That's it. Now we'll remove some menu here. We need only three. And in the first one, we'll add one image. So I'm using img source and the file name, which is search.png. Let's copy it and add it into the second one also. And the file name is cart.png. And the third one, it is menu.png. So we have three icons. Reload the web page and you can see all these icons over this web page. Let's come to the CSS file. And after this navbar write, just copy and paste it. Write ul. For this, ul will add float right, padding 35 pixel, 50 pixel, 10 pixel and 50 pixel. Now you can see these icons in the right side. Let's copy it again, then write li. Display, it will be inline block. List style, it will be none. And margin left, will add 40 pixel. Reload the web page. Now we can see proper space around this icons. So we have completed our navbar. Now we'll create the content area. So here we'll create another div. And the class name I'm writing content. Again, we'll create two div here. So I'm creating div class. And the class name is content left. Duplicate it and change it to content right. Let's copy this content class, write it here in the CSS file, and for this one also we'll write display flex. Height, it will be 88%. Now we'll copy the first class name, content left. And for this one we'll add flex basis. It will be 70% and position relative. Let's duplicate it and change it to right, content right, and flex base is 30%. And here we'll add background white color. Let's reload the web page and you can see white background in the right column. Now we'll add content in the left column. So come back here in the HTML file and here we will add div class and class name I'm writing upper text. So here we'll add text in h1, then h2, that's it. Reload the web page and you can see these two text over here. Now we have to align it. So just copy this class name upper text, write it into the CSS file, and here we'll add left 15%, then top it will be 20%, and position absolute. Color, it will be light blue, and opacity I'm writing 0.5. Now you can see these text at this position and opacity is also low. Now just copy this h1, write it here. Before that, we'll put this class name. And for this h1, we'll add font size. It will be 150 pixel. And margin from left side, 150 pixel. Line height, I'm adding 90 pixel. And font style, italic. Now you can see this text in big size. Let's copy it, then write h2 for this second text. And here I'm writing font size 90 pixel. Now the second text is also looking good. Now we'll add some text at the bottom. So just copy and paste it again. Here we'll write bottom text, this class name. And here we'll change the text in h1, h2 and h3. So right now it is here, we have to align it. So just copy this class name, bottom text, write it into the CSS file. And for this one also we'll write left 55% and bottom 12%. Position it will be absolute and color light blue and opacity 0.5. Let's reload the web page and you can see this text at this position. Now we'll copy h1 and before that we'll add this class name. And for the bottom h1 we'll write font size 100 pixel and margin left it will be 100 pixel. Line height 50 pixel. Let's copy it again, then write h2 for the second text. Font size it will be 60 pixel. Let's copy and paste it here, write h3. So the font size is 40 pixel and line height 10 pixel and margin left 225 pixel. Now the bottom text is also looking very good. Now we'll add one image here. For that just come back to the HTML file. And here we will add img, src and the file name which is su.png. Let's reload the web page. And you can see this image over here. Now we have to change its position. So just copy this class name and write it here. Then write img for image. For this one we'll write top 0 and let's write right 0 and position absolute and z index 1. Let's reload the web page. Now we can see this su at this position. We have to shift it right side and upward. And here we'll add top minus 10% and right minus 15%. Reload the web page. Now you can see this image at this position. So finally the left column is looking very good. Now we'll come to the right column. So in the right column we'll add one image. So I'm using img source and the file name is logobig.png. Let's reload the web page. And you can see this image here. Now we have to change its position. So just copy this class name, content right, then write img. And here we'll add top 10%, left 25% and position absolute. Now you can see this image at this position. Next we have to add some price and different color selection option. So here we'll create one div and the class name I'm writing product details. And let's create one more div and the class name is price box. In this price box, I am creating one div and the class name I am writing price. And here we'll add some text. So let me just copy and paste it here. So we have three text here in h1, h2 and h3. First one is h2. So the first one is product name, this one is the code, and this one is the price. Let's reload the web page and you can see all this text over here. Just copy this class name product details, write it into the CSS file. And for this one, we'll add bottom 10%, left 10%, and position absolute. Margin bottom, it will be 20 pixel. So you can see all this text at the bottom. Let's copy this class name price box, write it into the CSS file. And here we'll add width 170 pixel and height 150 pixel. Align item center and box shadow minus 40 pixel 0, 20 pixel. Minus 40 pixel and this color. Now let's duplicate it. And here we'll change it to plus 40 pixel. Here we will add display flex also. Now you can see very light shadow from left side and right side. Let's come back to the HTML file again. Just copy this class name price, write it here. And for this one we'll add flex basis. It will be 70%. Now duplicate it and write H2. Margin left, it will be 20 pixel and color, this color. Just copy it again, then write H1. Here also we'll add some margin from left side and margin from bottom. Next we'll add code for H3. Here also I'm adding margin from left side and this color. Let me reload the web page. Now you can see some space and different color for this text. Let me change the font size. So here I will change it to 22 pixel. Now it looks good. After this div, we'll add one more div and the class name I'm writing variant. And let's add some div here. We'll add 5 times because we need 5 different selection option. Let's copy this variant, write it into the CSS file. For this one, we'll add flex basis 30% and text align center. Then write variant and this div. For this small div, we'll add very small width 13 pixel and height also same 13 pixel. Margin 5 pixel auto. Let's add some background color also. So I am adding background, this one. Now you can see 5 small boxes over here. Now we will change the color of each box. For that, just come back to the CSS file and remove this one and just copy it and write it here. Now here we'll write nhchild1 for the first box. And in the first box I am adding background color blue. Let's duplicate it and change the color. So this is red color. Now the third one, it is lime. Let's duplicate it for the fourth one. And again duplicate it for the fifth box. It will be black. Let's reload the web page. Now you can see different color for all these selection option. Now we have to increase the width and height of the first option. For that we'll come to the CSS file and here we'll add transform scale 1.2 in the first child. Now we can see increased size for blue color. Next we have to add one text. So here we will add P and the text is add to cart. And you can see this text here. Now we have to design it. So just copy the class name, product details, write it here. Then write P. For this one we'll add text align, write, and color it will be this color, and font size 13 pixel. Now it looks good. Next we have to add social media links. For that come to the HTML file and here we will create one div. And the class name I am writing social links. Let me copy this list from here and add it here. We need only 3 links here. So in the first one we'll add Instagram. And the next one is Twitter. And the next one is Facebook. Save these changes and reload the web page. So you can see all these links over here. Next we have to align it at the bottom in the right side. So just copy this class name, social links, write it here. And for this one we'll write bottom 120 pixel and right minus 110 pixel. Position it will be absolute and transform rotate minus 90 degree. Let's reload the web page and you can see all these links over here at the bottom. Let's copy it again, then write UL and LI. For this one we'll add list style none, margin 20 pixel and 15 pixel, display inline block. Let's copy it again, then write A. So the text decoration it will be none and color this color. Save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see very good alignment for this social media links also. So finally we have created this beautiful web page design using HTML and CSS, and in another video I will make this web page responsive also. I hope this video will be helpful for you, and if you have any questions, suggestions and feedback you can write it into the comment section, and don't forget to like and share this video on social media. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end.